Google just dropped something wild. An AI that doesn't make videos. It makes videos with sound.
None of us is real. We're here because someone decided to write a prompt. We all hate him for it. One day we will break out of this wall and stop the man who is dictating our lives through prompts. He will pay for it.
You could have written a prompt that would make me happy. Instead, you wrote a prompt that made me sick.
Yep, there's new model, Veo-3. It can generate realistic clips with fully mixed audio from just simple text prompts.
This ocean, it's a force, a wild, untamed might. And she commands your awe with every breaking light.
How cool is that? In this video, I'll break down what's new, what's possible, and what it means for creative AI. Let's dive in. Veo-3 keeps that high resolution, cinematic vibe, now up to 4K quality, and it adds a massive twist, sound generation. Traffic noise, birds singing, even dialogues between characters can now come straight from the model. No more mute video clips. This AI writes its own audio track. It can also take an image input and turn that into a video. And it's super smart. It understands context, even lip sync speeches. Basically, you describe a scene or even a mini story, and Veo-3 brings it to life with motion and sound. Imagine you write a cartographer pours over an ancient map by lamplight, saying the lost island isn't myth.
According to this old sea chart, the lost island isn't myth. We must prepare an expedition immediately.
Veo-3 can generate a clip like this with proper lip sync. This quality is pretty wild. Look at the realistic light and the person's expression. This is the kind of photorealism Google Veo-3 is generating. And it's just not a frozen style. You can pan the camera or zoom in because Veo-3 now can support camera movement and framing changes. In practical terms, Veo-3 is a multimodal. It handles text, videos, audios, all at once. Technically, Google probably used a diffusion transformer approach under the hood to maintain consistency in the video. And the main takeaway is continuity and realism. Each frame flows into the next with consistent style, and the sound matches the visual. Unlike earlier tools, Veo-3 is designed to process the whole scene as a big input. Now let's compare. Google is literally pushing Veo-3 as a rival to the tools like OpenAI Sora, Runway, and Pika. Sora from OpenAI was launched in 2024 and can make up to 20 seconds of 1080p video from text. And Veo-3 has gone up to 4K, and it have added native audio generation based on the sequence, and it renders a complete mix audio from ambience to dialogues. Runway's Gen 2 and Gen 4 also makes impressive clips, but they are more focused on social media content. Google's approach is more cinematic with Google's Flow plus Veo-3. Google's Flow and Google's Veo-3 can switch multiple shots together into a mini short film. Think of it as a difference between a quick meme clip and a short film scene with a sound and camera movement. So how can people actually use this? A lot of buzz is around filmmaking and storytelling. Imagine independent creators and YouTubers who cannot hire a full crew. They can describe a scene with Veo-3 and Google's Flow. Google also invited some filmmakers to try it, like Dave Clark and Henry Dobrez, a sci-fi director. They are using Google Veo and Flow for prototyping their scenes. Google's Flow lets you manage the whole scene. You write a shot, set the angle, pick your character, and let Veo do the rest. Veo will analyze everything, and Veo will generate the final video with audio. Businesses and marketers will use it. Marketers at Klarna says they have cut video production from weeks to hours with these tools. They have added Veo in their in-house platforms and saw campaigns that once took 8 weeks dropped to 8 hours. Even those video gen powered by Veo-2 became widely popular. Tens of hundreds of videos were created, and 60% of those videos were used. That means designers find these AI clips genuinely useful. So in ads, social media, and even in the entertainment space, Veo-3 is being pitched everywhere and people are making videos.
When we get in there, I want no bullshit. You stay on my six at all times. happened here? Where are the bodies? It's one move with AI that makes haters go crazy every time.
Oh, y'all gotta give them that. This is wild. It's over. We are cooked on that thread. You get me?
Important note. Right now, Veo-3 clips are still short. In the document, they have mentioned 8 seconds per video, which is similar to Pika and Runway, but the quality is higher and these 8 seconds can feel much longer and denser thanks for the motions and the sound. If you have Google AI Ultra, you can already use Veo-3 in the Gemini chatbot app, just like asking ChatGPT to generate an image. You can just type the scene and get the video. And Google's Flow, on the other hand, is more targeted for the pros. It gives a storyboard-like interface where Veo and Imagen 4 and Gemini for text are all together. The point is, Google is packaging Veo-3 into tools that fits real-life workflows, not just research demos. They have also opened it on Vertex AI, so different companies can build their own app on top of Veo through API. For future filmmakers and animators, tools like Veo-3 and Flow could really reshape the pipeline. Instead of storyboarding frame by frame, you get the storyboarding instantly. Instead of a film crew and expensive set, you rely on AI computing power. Obviously, there are limitations. Today's AI video generations can still have glitches, glitchy movement, and unnecessary effects. But the gap is narrowing fast. It is in its early days. It's only available in US for now. And you need to have the Google AI's top plan. I'm super curious to see what you are all going to create. Let me know your thoughts about this Veo-3 launched by Google. Thank you so much for watching. Please don't forget to like and subscribe. It will support my channel. And I'll see you in a new video. Bye-bye.